Welcome to the Conservation of Momentum video. In exercise 1, we'll be leveling the track. Attach the feet to each end of the track. To do this, you will slide the square nut into the side of the track, and then tighten the thumb screws to lock the feet to the track. You can change the height of each end of the track by tightening or loosening the feet themselves. Set the height to approximately level. Slide the motion sensors onto each end of the track. Each of these will be used to monitor one cart. Plug each sensor into the data acquisition interface. Measure the masses of each of the two weights and each of the two carts. It's probably a good idea to mark one of each with a piece of masking tape to make sure you know which mass measurement corresponds to which object. Open the capstone file called Conservation of Momentum. Put one cart on the track. Press record and give the cart a push. Press stop. Repeat this a total of 5 times, all in the same direction and all without changing anything. For each run, use the highlight tool in Capstone to select the portion of the run where the cart is slowing down on its own, and note the slope of the graph during that section. The spread of these 5 values will give you an idea what the uncertainty on your slope is. Once you know that uncertainty, adjust the height of one end of the track and take runs in both directions. Continue making height adjustments until the magnitudes of the slopes are the same in each direction. In exercise 2, we'll be comparing total initial momentum to total final momentum, and total initial kinetic energy to total final kinetic energy for elastic collisions. Note that each cart has a Velcro strip on one end and a pair of magnets on the other. The Velcro is to cause very inelastic collisions, and the magnets are to cause very elastic collisions. For this exercise, we will point the magnets inwards. Press record in Capstone and push one cart towards the other. Then press stop. Note which cart is being recorded by which sensor. Collect 3 runs with no masses on either cart. Then add a mass to the initially stationary cart and collect another 3 runs. Add the second mass to the initially stationary cart and collect another 3 runs. Now remove both masses and add one to the cart that you push. Collect another 3 runs. Now add the second mass to the cart you push and collect another 3 runs. This should give you a total of 15 runs. For each run, you will find the velocity of the moving cart just before collision and the velocity of each cart just after collision. In exercise 3, we'll be doing the same thing we did in exercise 2, but for inelastic collisions. Remove the two masses and turn the carts around so that the Velcro is facing inwards. As before, press record in Capstone, give one of the carts a push towards the other, and press stop after the collision. Just like before, collect a total of 15 runs with the same mass combinations.